shots, yep. Eyes up. No breathing, no breathing.
Everybody,
grab a bag, including the upper substation. You can use that to any bad guy, any bag. Grab a bag, please. Grab a bag.
Any bag, guys, any bag, any bag.
Good, good. Fire back, yeah, you're blocking good. Fire back right away. Blocking good, fire back right away. Exactly.
Okay, everybody. New week. Technique of the week. Fakes and feints, okay? Fakes and feints. We're just going to go through the real basic ones. For those members that are a little bit newer, for those that know, but don't know, whenever we start a new technique of the week, early on the week, we start real basic, okay? And we start to build up on that technique of the week as we get through for Sunday, okay? Okay, we're just going to work with real basic, fakes and feints. All right, we're going to start with some real basic boxing. Incorporating some basic things to create another opening to land another big basic combo. Alright? So what we're going to do on the bag.
Angles too, Edwin.
We're going to start with just a simple jab cross. One, two. Then from here, a lead leg push kick. I just covered push kicks last week. We're going to roll right into this week using what we did last week, okay? So remember, when you make a push kick, you need to bring that lead leg up exactly like if you were going to throw a push kick. So you need to come flat to the ground. What I mean by that is, don't bring it low and certainly don't bring it up too high. Okay, you need to make your opponent think that you're actually going to throw a push kick. Right? Whenever we're throwing push kicks, remember what the counter on the defense is, okay? He starts throwing push kicks up, he throws it again, I'm going to drop my hands to grab. He throws it again, I'm going to drop one hand to parry. He throws it again, I might use the opposite hand to parry. All of which involve me opening up my face and dropping my hand. With one hand, or with one, or the other. Okay? So when we fake, now you're going to get your opponent to drop their hands, which is going to open up their face. So they're going to go right back to the face with some boxing. Okay? Later on in the week, as we progress, we can start incorporating elbows, head kicks, lots of different things to go back to serious when we start realizing the same thing. Okay? Now, one thing I want to clear up. When we use the face, it's not always faking a kick, faking an elbow. There's a lot of different things in. Time that jab as that lead leg is landing from the face. One more time, really slow. Jab cross, I fake that push kick. And as it's landing, I'm going to land that jab again. Any questions? Nope. Everyone got it? Okay, let's do it. We're going to do this for one entire round, okay? We're going to do a little bit of bad work, and then we're going to partner up at the end and do some drills, okay? Let's go, guys. Begin. One, two, take the push kick. Another one, two, right after. One, two, take the push kick. Another one, two, right after. Way too low, buddy. Every time you're punching, you
spin out to your left, Edwin. Spin out to your left and then left hook. Body, 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 body. Good shell.
After you're done with your second jab, cross.
definitely watching this later. Holy shit.
Very good.
Heads up, watch your feet. Good stuff. Spin out to your right and then left hook to the body.
Some of you guys may have noticed that when you were trying to do your combination, you're going 1-2, back up, and then when you go to the second one, you're jammed up, right? The back is a little too close, you can't punch from here. Remember, if your opponent jams you up and you want to throw a punch,
turn it into an elbow,
okay? You still have options. And actually, it's
smart there you go.
To throw the elbow. Why hit with a padded surface when you can hit it with the elbow, okay? Another situation where you might want to use the elbow after you fake. Listen, the first time when we were going back to the face, because we were anticipating that our opponent's going to drop their hands to counter the push kick or to grab the push kick. Sometimes when you fake that push kick, your opponent's just going to show up.
Throw a check hook when you're spinning out, Edwin.
They just see you move it and they just might show up. You might get a little hesitation out of it. If they're already blocking here and they have a good guard, sometimes someone with a good guard is going to use their elbows to block the body and have a nice tight guard up here. Not like this, where I'm leaving the body open. If you see that they have a nice tight guard, when you can fake that push kick, you can't throw a push kick, you can't go to the body, and the face is covered up. All right? So what you want to do, normally you want to do, don't throw a punch when someone's blocking, don't kick when someone's blocking. You have to find an opening or do something else. So what you're going to do in this situation, even if your opponent is blocking, you can still throw a big crossing elbow right to the guard or a big up elbow right through the guard to split it open or to rattle your opponent's head.
Head movement, head movement.
You guys that watch some of the Thai fights, especially on our YouTube channel, you will see a Thai fighter will get caught in the corner, shelling up. The opponent will just start throwing elbows, even though they're landing on the guard. The fighter still goes down, okay? Elbows are incredibly dangerous, strong weapons. Even through the guard, you can knock somebody out with an elbow. So that's what we're gonna do next. We're gonna throw that same jab cross. 1-2, when we fake now, we're gonna land a little bit closer because we're anticipating that our opponent is shelling up, okay?
There you go, body, body.
On the right side, on the power side, if you have any stop calls, you're left. Okay? If you want to throw an up elbow, it's fine too.
Good stuff.